Yes, absolutely. But also, no, not necessarily. Let's talk about Supernatural on the Oculus Quest today on BMF. So is Supernatural, the new fitness game that is on the Oculus Quest, actually worth $20 a month? Now, having used it for a week now, I have some thoughts and opinions. These are my opinions. I'm also going to allow you to have your own opinion, obviously, but please don't bring negativity and hate into the comments because that's not what this channel is all about. So let's talk about exactly what Supernatural is and whether it actually is worth that $20 fee. Supernatural at its core is really a workout experience that at times feels like a rhythm game. To be totally honest with you, it's freaking hard at times, so it's not super enjoyable if you're looking to do something just to have fun. Now, many people have compared this game to Beat Saber and called it a Beat Saber clone. Are there elements in this that are very similar to Beat Saber? Yes, obviously. There are two batons that you use to slash at orbs to the beat of music. So there you go. That is essentially what Beat Saber is, but there is a lot more to Supernatural than just slashing at orbs to music. For one thing, even though Beat Saber does have 360 levels now, there is the whole 360 movement to this game that I really like how it works. Supernatural will have you moving in a total circle, and it always ends up having you centered by the time you're done facing forward, but you are gonna need room around you because you'll be slashing and lunging all in different directions to the beat of that music. I actually really like how they have you doing squats and lunges, and let me tell you, there are a lot of squats and lunges in some of these songs. As the triangles come at you, you'll either be doing a squat or a lunge, or holding a squat at some times, or bouncing back and forth between lunges while slashing at the different orbs. There are a lot of really cool things that they do with the movements back and forth that I really like. It allows you to get into the rhythm of the actual music, but it also really works the muscles in your legs and in your arms. In fact, one of the biggest differences I found between Supernatural and Beat Saber is the intentional nature of the actual orbs and the squats. Beat Saber is meant to be a game that you enjoy that is difficult and hard. This game is meant to be an experience that is difficult and hard for a purpose to actually tone your muscles and give you a workout. So that to me right there sets things apart. There are a lot of far reaches, twists. The game actually encourages you to twist your body and use full force and full movement with your arms. In fact, it actually takes points away if you don't do that. Now, as far as the songs go, these are all licensed tracks, and that really feeds into why this is $20 a month, but we'll talk about that here in just a minute. There are quite a few songs from some bigger artists like Charlie Puth in this, so you'll hear music that you probably have heard many times before and might even be something that you really enjoy listening to. But music really isn't the thing that I enjoy about this experience. Although it is fun with the music, I think that's secondary than the actual gameplay and the trainers. Now, let's talk about the trainers really quick. In this game, unlike any other workout game that I've ever played in VR, you have trainers actually speaking to you and encouraging you, real life people. Now, it's not live, it's obviously pre-taped, but there is a handful of trainers that actually talk to you while you're doing the workout and push you to do better. Now, that doesn't sound like it would be enjoyable or it would work very well, but I gotta tell you, there were times when I was running out of steam and I listened to the trainers encouraging me and saying certain things, and it really does help and push you to want to do better. On top of talking to you during the workouts, they actually will start off each workout series talking to you, explaining what's happening in the workout, introducing the location that you're in, and even showing you how to properly do some of the movements. At the end of the workout, they do also talk to you, encourage you, and lead you in some stretches most of the time to get your body cooled down, which is one thing I think a lot of people forget about in virtual reality, is actually warming up and cooling down, which this game does both, which is really cool. Speaking of the workouts, each workout is led by one of the handful of trainers, and the workout changes every day. Every day you go on, there's a brand new workout to be able to play through. One of my favorite parts about this experience is actually the locations. They are amazing looking locations. You get to go to some tropical places, some deserts, Africa, Asia, Europe. It's just a really cool mixture of locations, and they're not just 360 degree photos either. The locations remind me a lot of the way that they captured real VR fishing, in that there's scale and there's distance, and it's really a 3D environment that you feel like you're actually there while you're working out. There's also some other cool features in Supernatural that set it apart, including connecting a heart rate monitor, as well as a dedicated app for iOS and Android that allows you to connect with other users and encourage each other by seeing a leaderboard, liking their posts, commenting back and forth, and keeping track of your workouts all from your mobile phone, which I think is a really cool idea. I wasn't really sure how it would function, but it's cool to go through and find new friends, see how they're doing, encourage each other by liking it, making comments. It's created a whole platform that's very different than just a leaderboard, and I think that's a really cool and innovative way to encourage each other to continue to work out. So now that you kind of have a picture of what Supernatural is, why does it cost $20 a month, and is it worth that $20 a month? Let's break down why it's $20 a month before we answer that question. Number one, the music. So this is a big thing. In fact, it's the main reason why it's not overseas right now. It's just in North America or just in Canada and the US because of music licensing issues. They're using some big tracks, licensed music from artists that normally aren't in a game like this, so that's the reason it's not in those locations, but it's also one of the reasons that it costs more. It's one unfortunate trade-off of having known music, it costs more to license it, which is one of the things that builds into that $20 a month price. Another factor is the trainers. Now, obviously these aren't real live trainers in the sense that they're actually there with you, talking to you, but they are live in the sense that they're real people standing in front of you having a pre-recorded workout. And now they're adding these workouts on a weekly basis, which increases the amount of money that they're putting into this game weekly. That's another factor that goes into this $20 a month. That kind of gives you a picture as to why. Now, that doesn't really answer whether it's worth that or not, so let's address that. Whether Supernatural is actually worth the $20 monthly fee is highly subjective, so keep that in mind as we go through some of these quick points on what I think. First, let's address the price point. $20 a month is high. Am I going to pay it? We will see. Probably, because I like the way that this program works, I like the encouragement that I get from it, and I like the workout and what I'm able to do and get from the program. It still remains to be seen after the trial if I continue on with this, but my inclination is to say yes just due to the last week worth of workouts. Now, not everyone's gonna feel that way, and that's totally fine. I would much rather have a lower price point, but to me, it's worth paying that because I get exercise, encouragement, and it makes me feel better. I personally think that they should try to figure out a way to lower the cost per month down to $15, maybe $10 would be better. At least $10 a month would be awesome because then I think they would get an even bigger group of people more interested in trying it out for longer periods of time. To me, the price is higher than I think that it should be. Now, I've mentioned a couple of reasons it's that high, and personally, although I think that it's great to have licensed tracks like this, I almost wish that they would have less licensed tracks if that would mean the price was lower. Heck, I don't care if it's got licensed music or not, so take out the licensed music or even give an option for a non-licensed version of the tracks and do it that way if possible and drop the price down. Whatever it takes, I think the audience really needs to be larger for this to be successful, and having less licensed or no licensed music would allow that price to be lower. To me, I don't think that the trainers are a negative. I think that that should stay the same, even if that keeps the price at a little bit higher of a point, because I enjoy having that encouragement, and I think it adds to a realism of actually having someone encouraging you to keep going. So now that that's out of the way, are there any other real negatives to this game? Well, that depends. If you absolutely hate rhythm games, you don't like Beat Saber, and it's not interesting at all to you, then this might not be for you because there are a lot of similarities. Now, the game does feel different because it is a workout and a lot of the mechanics that they use might be similar but used in a different way, and I think that that's a good thing, but some of these levels are incredibly hard. Now, you don't fail the levels by missing notes. That's another key aspect to this. It's all about doing what you can. But when those notes are flying in your face, it can get hectic and very hard to keep up. So I equate doing some of these songs to some of the higher expert difficulty levels on Beat Saber at times. The game is designed to adapt to you though, so that adaptation will allow the game to adjust to meet what you can do and push you farther. One thing that I should have mentioned before is the calibration of this game is a really cool aspect. It actually calibrates your squat height, your lunge depth, and exactly what you're able to do so that it continuously pushes you to do better but doesn't push you so hard that you can't do it. Now, there is an exception with the pro workout because that one is just a nuts workout that is absolutely crazy and is like the equivalent of playing on Expert Plus or something on Beat Saber. Whether it's actually worth $20 a month really comes down to personal opinion and whether you have the discretionary income to spend that and it's worth it for you to be able to do exercises at home and have the licensed music and trainers encouraging you. To me, The licensed music isn't such a big thing, but having the trainers, the environments, and the style of workout that I can do a 20-minute workout every morning or evening and have a great sweat going on really means a lot to me, and that makes it worth the current price to me. There are a few other small things, like the hitboxes at times could be a little bit more accurate with the notes, as sometimes I would miss, but honestly, that's not that big of a deal. As long as I'm getting the workout in, I don't really care. I really do like their point system and how you accrue points to try to get to a certain level, and I even like their rating system where you can get platinum, double platinum, triple platinum, silver, bronze, depending on how you do with the level, and you can go back and do it again and try to get a higher score. When it really comes down to it, it's not my job to tell you whether it's worth it or not. It's my job to tell you what is included and what I think, and you have to make that personal decision yourself. So we've kind of talked about what Supernatural is, how it functions, why it's $20 a month, whether I think that it's worth it or not. So this is really subjective. This video was really meant to give you the information that you need, give you my opinion on it, and allow you to decide for yourself whether it's worth it to you specifically. Now, it may not be. And that's totally okay, but there is a group of people out there that want this and are totally okay with having it, and I just happen to be a part of that group. Like I said, there are some negative things about this, including the monthly fee and a couple of other small things, but honestly, if it's something that you're interested in, at least give it a shot in the trial. I think you're going to be surprised at how well it works and how good of a workout it actually is. Those are my thoughts on Supernatural on the Oculus Quest and whether it's actually worth that $20 a month fee. What do you think about Supernatural, both as an experience, aside from the $20 fee, and the $20 fee as well? Let me know down in the comments, but please, let's not start any fighting, and let's just have a great time bouncing things back and forth about why we believe what we do, but all value each other's opinions. If you want to get the most out of your Oculus Quest, don't forget to hit that subscribe button down there and hit the bell icon. Plus, if you want to check out more of my videos, you can find them right there. Thank you so much for watching. Stay safe, and happy questing.